As we know, most corals contain tiny single-celled organisms called symbiodinium. These are actually dinoflagellates. Yep, those snotty, bubbly scourges of so many reef tanks. But they're not that kind of dinoflagellate. They're a helpful kind that uses chlorophyll, just like a plant, to produce food for itself, and it gives some of that food back to the coral that it lives inside. Hi guys and girls, I'm Reefman, and this time around we're talking about light spectrums and exactly how it impacts your coral. With today's modern LED fixtures, you can often tune your lights to whatever color you like. If you want them red, set it that way. Green? Blue? You can really do whatever you like with your lights. But what is best for your coral? Light at the wrong color or intensity will severely impact the health of your coral. And after all, the coral is really the reason why we spend all that money on those fancy lights. Being able to set our LED fixtures to some specific color like I was doing is really just icing on the cake. Think of it as a party trick. What's best for your eyes is not going to be what's best for the corals in a lot of cases. Let's get back to those dinoflagellates. I mentioned that they're using chlorophyll to produce food just like a plant does. There's a bunch of different kinds of chlorophyll, but the two most common in our coral's symbiodinium are chlorophyll A and chlorophyll C2. Knowing that, we could do a quick bit of research and find out that chlorophyll A has an absorption peak around 465 nanometers and another one at 665 nanometers, while chlorophyll C2 has just one absorption peak around 449 nanometers. You might recall that white sunlight is really just made out of a mix of colors all coming from the sun. If we put the light through a prism, we can actually see that rainbow of color, the light spectrum. If we think of light as a wave of energy coming from the sun, each color has a slightly different wavelength. That's just the distance between the peaks of the waves. We measure those wavelengths in nanometers, and that's just 1/1,000,000th of a meter. Chlorophyll A responds to two different wavelengths, about 465 nanometers, which is a very deep blue-violet color, and 665 nanometers, which is kind of an orangey-red. Chlorophyll C2 responds to only one light color, around 449 nanometers, which is just a violet blue color. If we look at the data sheets for popular LED lights, you can see that the LEDs that they're using often match those colors. Remember, of course, a 450 nanometer royal blue LED mainly puts out that wavelength, but it also provides some below and some above it, probably covering chlorophyll A's 465 nanometer peak as well. Similarly, a red LED will likely excite chlorophyll A's 665 nanometer peak. So it does make sense to look at the light spectrum that's produced by a light that you're interested in, just to ensure that it covers those peaks. And of course, you shouldn't program it in a way where you just turn off all the red LEDs and you don't give the coral that color. Don't take my word for it though. There's a paper that looked at exactly this, published back in 2007, titled Evaluation of Artificial Light Regimes and Substrate Types for Aquaria Propagation of the Staghorn Coral Acroporus solitariensis. There's a link down below in the description if you want all the nitty-gritty details, but they tested the growth and survival of Acroporus solitariensis using four different metal halide bulbs, a 5500K, a 10K, a 14K, and a 20K. They also tested two different substrates onto which their frags were glued using superglue. They tested concrete and marble. The team measured the weight of the corals, adjusting with marble or cement tiles that didn't contain corals, just to ensure that their results wouldn't be affected by something leaching out of the substrate. They measured this weight every 5 days for 85 days and removed frags that died at each weighing. Interestingly, the paper contains the spectrum of each bulb that they were using. Remember, they're metal halide bulbs. And you can see the highlighted bands where chlorophyll A responds over that spectrum. See how the 5500K bulb doesn't really have peaks anywhere at all except red? And how the 20K has large peaks down in violet blue and a small bump also in red? That's what you want your light spectrum to be. You want to have peaks in the ranges that your coral can actually use, like that 20K bulb has. The team found that the substrate the coral was attached to didn't really matter at all. But the color of the light had a significant impact on the health and the growth of the corals. 5500K and 10,000K metal halide light was the worst, with only 52% of corals surviving at all. 20,000K light, with the peaks in the proper places, was the best, with 83% of fragments surviving to the end of the study. Light also strongly impacted the coral's growth. Acropora frags under 14K and 20K bulbs grew much more than the tanks under 5500K or 10K tanks. Now, this study was done back in 2007, when there was still very much a question as to if LEDs could grow coral at all. Of course, we know today that LEDs will work just fine, and I bet most of you have LEDs over your reef tanks at home right now. It's important to consider just how we tune those lights, though, how we program them. Make sure you don't completely turn off the red LEDs, and also make sure that the blue and the violet and the royal blue LEDs are also on. This might end up looking a little bit more blue than you would usually program to your eyes, but the coral will thank you with a better survival rate and overall better growth. LEDs tend to produce a very small range of color, centered on a specific wavelength, and they're sold as royal blue, red, etc., things like that, just on that one single central wavelength. Take a look at how you've programmed your lights with this in mind. You want to have peaks in intensity around violet and blue, and also some on the other end around red. Make some adjustments if you need to. I think your corals will reward you over the next few months. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you next time. Bye.